Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for your first battle?
Yeah!
That was not as good as it could have been. First round battle of the evening. Ladies and gentlemen, he is 5-2 in competition. He is from Long Island, New York. Ladies and gentlemen, put it together for Mike Feeney. Mike, happy to have you here at the tournament. What happened back there?
I don't know. I smashed something off a table. Was that a drink or a phone? Or?
Nice.
Great start, huh? Here we go.
See, here's the problem, though. These roast battlers, they don't get paid shit, so tough shit, you know?
Yeah. You're really on your own.
We'll buy you another drink. I'm sorry, miss. I guess I'll buy it, Mike. Thanks.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Okay, so his competition, 3-1 in competition from the great state of Illinois. Put your hands together nice and loud for Emily Winter. Happy to have you back, Emily. I'm going to have you call it in the air.
Tails.
Tails it is. You want to go first or defer?
I'll defer.
Mike Feeney's going first. Emily Winter's going second. One round championship tournament. Come on, motherfuckers. Put your hands together. Let's roast.
Nice to meet you, by the way. We have never met.
Never
so,
met.
heard great things. Emily, you frumpy, moon-faced nothing. Emily started a comedy festival called What a Joke, not to be confused with her top Google search, What is a Joke?
Thank you, Kmart brand John Mulaney. Okay.
That's good.
Mike looks like he peaked while Smirnoff icing someone at a funeral.
Thank you, Midlife Crisis, Miss Piggy. Now, Emily grew up in the Midwest, where her and her friend's idea of fun was drinking in cornfields and trying to tip Emily over while she slept.
Thank you, you empty sock. Okay. As a pale, forgettable, completely average white man, Mike has two great fears in life, the sun and affirmative action.
Okay. Emily started dating her boyfriend after his roommate committed suicide because the only thing big enough to fill the void was Emily's pussy.
Thank you, you charming college rapist. Okay. Mike looks like he got eliminated from The Bachelorette after mixing a cocktail with his dick.
Emily's a big feminist, which explains why that joke was 77% as funny. Emily, you Midwestern meh. You look like you squirt ranch dressing.
Right. Thank you, Whiskey Dick Jimmy Neutron. Okay.
That's where we go.
Mike's mom is a lunch lady, and Mike married his college girlfriend, which means his mom has stuffed literally hundreds more tacos than he has.
Holy shit. What a fucking battle right there, guys. One more time. Give it up for them one more time. Opening round. Opening round of the tournament. Two of the best. Very excited about that battle. Let's go down to the judges' table. Rich Voss.
That really was white-on-white crime right there. They both were great. It was a lot of fun. I got to lean towards Mike because one of yours kind of didn't make it, and all of his hit. Every one of yours hit except one and all of his hits. So I got to give it to Mike on that one.
Mike Feeney gets one vote from the living legend, Rich Voss. Eli Sairs can give feedback, but you're not voting on these. These are tournaments. The truth is we just don't trust you.
Yeah, I understand.
So a little bit of feedback here. What'd you think of this battle?
I liked both these chicks. really great battle.
All right. Joe List, what do you think, buddy?
Yeah, that was killer. I mean, that's as good as a battle. It makes me hope or wish that somebody else in the tournament will die so the loser can get back in the tournament. That's how good it was. And also, I don't like a couple of the people in the tournament. I hope they die. Yeah, I thought it was killer, and I agree with Rich. The only joke that didn't hit was Emily's. They both killed so hard, but the one joke didn't really hit. So I guess I got to give it to Mike, but as close as they come right there.
Two votes for Mike Feeney. The crowd is not happy about that. Good. Bonnie McFarlane, what'd you think?
This was a great battle. I was shocked at how good it was. And I feel bad because I've been working on this paper about how there's more shitty comedians named Mike than shitty female comedians. And so this makes it hard now because I had it. I think Mike Feeney, I think we've seen this before. You know, it was good, but it's like,
I agree.
Boring. So I'm going to go with Emily.
One vote for Emily Winter. Big J, house judge. What'd you think, buddy?
Did you fucking put your headshot on every copy? On every copy of the bracket? Why don't you put pictures of the fucking comics doing the thing? Hosted by very dramatic Louis J. Gomez. Hey, America, it's your chance to vote.
Big J, what do you think of the battle?
I'll be honest, dude, I paid very little attention. I was consumed. No, they both.
Do you
they
think
both,
I designed they, that
I,
myself?
They yeah, absolutely, I do.
Fine, I did.
You know, it'll look great in that little empty space right there. Mike Feeney, nobody, and I'll say nobody, has pulled off the cuffed short sleeve button down since a man by the name of Brandon Walsh in a little zip code called 90210. They both kicked ass in that one, but I think, yeah, if I'm just going by the numbers there, I think Mike pulled it off by one, so I think Mike got it.
Your winner, Mike Feeney! Your loser, Emily Winter! Hug it out. Great battle. Thank you.